Gram School. Hello, my name is Drewy.
And my name is Abby. Today is Tuesday, December 8th, 2020.
The links for the announcements are sent to the teacher every day and will also be sent to your GMSTP Live Google Classroom each morning so you can rewatch it if you want.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
On December 7, 1941, Japan attacked Pearl Harbor. On the next day, U.S. President Franklin Roosevelt declared war on Japan, which entered the U.S. into the World War II.
The Day of Infamy is how we Americans have come to remember the attack on Pearl Harbor. And we owe that phrase to the American president who knew exactly what was called for in a moment of crisis. David Martin takes us back.
This is John Daly speaking from the CBS newsroom in New York. The Japanese have attacked the American naval base at Pearl Harbor, Hawaii, and our defense facilities at Manila, capital of the Philippines.
President Roosevelt knew war was coming, but not like this.
The attack apparently was made on naval and military activities on the principal island of Oahu.
On that Sunday, he was working on his stamp collection in his private study in the White House, now preserved in this panoramic photo.
The phone rings at this desk. It's the Secretary of Navy on the line.
Herman Eberhardt is the curator at the FDR Library in Hyde Park, New York.
And he tells the president that the Pearl Harbor Naval Base is under attack.
It was 1:47 p.m. Washington time.
And what was the president's first reaction?
First reaction was to shout into the phone, no, sort of in a state of disbelief.
The critical hours that followed were recorded moment by moment by the people around the president, sometimes in hastily scrawled notes on random scraps of paper, now on display for the 75th anniversary of the attack.
We wanted to take people inside the White House on one of the most important days in American history.
Paul Sparrow is director of the FDR Library.
It was the worst day of his presidency. It was the worst military defeat in American history.
In an hour and 5 minutes, the battleship Arizona was completely destroyed and four others severely damaged.
I think December 7th, 1941 is perhaps the most important day in American history. It is the transition day when we shifted from being an isolationist nation to being a global superpower.
Fortnite, Among Us, Overwatch. Could these video games become part of a school sport? And better yet, can you get into college just by playing them?
People have been debating whether video games should become a school sport for a few years now. Some schools have already made it official and created video game teams of their own, and others have argued against. You may not believe it, but there are many good reasons why video games should become a school sport. Students can learn critical life skills such as teamwork, focus, planning, and can learn how to be calm under pressure. Students can even learn about computer codes and game development if they participate in this esport. And one of the biggest pros is that it can help kids who aren't good at other physical sports get into college. But this esport isn't all good. Those who disagree with video games becoming a school sport say that sitting isn't a sport. In other words, sitting in front of a computer monitor, straining their eyes 4 hours a day isn't a sport and takes away from the time that students could be exercising. If too many kids trade their soccer balls for keyboards and headsets, it could cause long-term problems for this generation and future generations.
However, lots of other sports like spelling bees don't endorse physical activity, which makes them not much different than video games. What do you think?
Should video games become a school sport, or should it stay as the fun hobby that most people see it as?
Teachers, yesterday you received an email from Ms. Kubota with a list of students who have not finished their iReady testing. Please make sure to administer the iReady testing to them immediately this morning and continue through the rest of the day, teachers.
We'll announce the winner for Guess the Teacher.
Wednesday, so turn in your work by 3:30. And also, don't forget that Christmas is in 17 days, aka 2 weeks and 3 days. Oh, and one more thing. On Wednesday, there will be another Among Us event. It will be from 4 to 6 p.m.
The link for the Among Us activity is in the Google Classroom GMS TV account, and also the Internet Security Assembly will be held next week and not this week.
And that breaking news tonight, the man known as America's greatest pilot has died, Chuck Yeager, passing away at the age of 97. Yeager was the first person to break the sound barrier and one of the most decorated test pilots in Air Force history.
Yeah.